payroll.
Okay, good morning, one by one. Good morning, everybody. I'm Josephine Castro-Cotor of Martino State University, Goa, Camarines Sur. And I'm a PE professor there for almost 30 years. And I've been coaching for 29 years, both men and women. And then before, it's high school, boys and girls. Now I'm coaching basketball, men and women, and also basketball boys in high school. Now, it's my first time here at Junior NBA, Junior WNBA. Now, I had a different experience. Every year I'm with NBTC or with the coaches convention, but in here it's really the grassroots. So, it's a very nice experience, very inspiring that all the volunteer coaches are participating how to do the correct position, stance, and everything. So it's very nice, and I think I'm in the right direction now, because at my age I cannot really play. I'm into officiating too, and then my passion is really basketball coaching is teaching, but we have to be committed, we have to be devoted, because if we will not do that, there will be no nice result with the girls, the boys, and maybe someday we could have these boys and girls have a very nice and good job. Actually, my instruction to my boys, my girls in my team is I want them to enjoy while learning. So they will study. I'm giving them 4 years to finish their course, 5 is the most, but I want them to learn and finish their course at the same time, enjoy their passion, especially basketball.
So, ma'am, how do you find the this event by Alaska supporting the junior NBA, finding new talents? How was it? How hard it is
for you, hard
for you to choose?
Imagine their only time the break is that break time, the liquid, the water, then go back to their station, and so on. But you can see in their faces, they really have that eagerness and that eagerness to learn more. Though they know for a fact that only after today, they will again be eliminated. Some of them will be eliminated, and then there will only be a few who will be chosen and go to the national. So they really strive themselves. Sometimes, nanggigigil sila eh. Kaya kumbaga nawawala ng focus. Pero sabi namin, just enjoy what you are doing. But because if you are enjoying, the flow will be good. So it's hard. Some of them is something you will see their faces, in their eyes, the eagerness, and then some of them, the paleness and the lips that they're really grasping the air, the liquid and everything, but they're still there.
Ma'am, considering at your age, no? And yet
I'm 58.
You are 58, and yet you were lucky enough to join the coaches. So, parang how does it feel joining like the ranks of the younger ones?
Yeah, I'm very much overwhelmed, because as the way I look at them, the coaches that we have in here, they're very much younger than me. But as the saying goes, learning and then education never stops. Even though at my age, I learned a lot from these young people.
And what did you impart to them naman po?
The wisdom. And then actually, there is a comparison of we have the different techniques, the skills in the building this young age, and of course the facilities, because it's very much different. The facilities before, the facilities now, it's very much different. And so everything is there. And today, because of this junior NBA, with the participation of the coaches, the volunteer coaches, wow. These people, Coach Jeff and Coach Jay and everybody in the NBA in Alaska, my God, everybody is healthy. We don't know each other very well yet, but we are healthy because of basketball. I mean, we know what to do. But just one instant, one instruction, everything, everybody knows what to do with just one instruction, because it's basketball.
So do you think Alaska's event like this is a parang it will give more to the
it will give or add more improvement when, especially in basketball, because Alaska takes it from the grassroots. They get it from the grassroots, because grassroots is important. It's very hard to develop players, especially those who already know. Well, in fact, what they know is not really the exact fundamentals, the fundamental skills. It's better to teach the children who really doesn't know anything, and then if you will teach players who have a little knowledge, it's hard for them to change what they have been doing. But if you start from the grassroots, you will really develop a very good player someday.
So what can you say to the other coaches na, you know, for next year?
I am encouraging other coaches, because some coaches, pardon the reference, and then modesty aside, everybody knows how to play basketball. Everybody knows how to interpret basketball. Everybody knows how to coach basketball. But the thing is, a little learning is dangerous. Sometimes, you know, I've been coaching and appreciating a little learning, then they will tell you something, anything that they know, which is not really the right thing. The right thing in basketball, the right term, the right, and everything. But it's just that these coaches must go into further, learning, training, and then convention, and training, especially training, because everybody knows, not everybody knows the right thing or the right skills, the right training in basketball. Because sometimes what we have been doing, especially in the province, there are many people who are into coaching, but it's not really the right thing to coach. They should know how to discipline the players, the right attitude, and then the correct skills that an athlete should have. Some athletes, porket magaling, ayun, parang inaano na nila eh, na magtawag dito. Special treatment, which tumalaki yung ulo. Kumbaga, sabi nga naman, hindi pa man sumisikat laos na eh. Kasi parang akala nila sila na yung pinakamagaling. Pero karamihan sa magagaling, hindi nakapagtapos.
So this event really helps you learn more.
Yeah. And then they are, imagine, the parents are with them to support them financially, emotionally, spiritually, everything is there. And that's why I love being with here. My kababayan, who is also a coach, told me to come here, I think for the past 2 years, but it only materialized this year, because I always have my schedule, at the same time with this schedule in junior NBA training. And I did not really regret. I'm happy I'm here. Actually, I just came from Bicol yesterday. I arrived early in the morning, then came in here. And then tonight, I'm going back to Bicol again.